Hey guys, Moidog here, and today I've got some exciting news about a brand new free game coming soon to Steam, Operation Harsh Doorstop. I'm sure many of you have heard about this game, but in case you haven't, it's a completely community-supported, community-developed game led by BlueDrake42 and Drakeling Labs. I had a chance to play this in an extremely early alpha build, so early in fact that you'll see at the top of the screen it simply says prototype. So while you are watching this gameplay, do take into consideration that this is still very early stages, and a lot, or maybe everything you see here can change. I'll also say that although I was given a key for free,
almost everyone who played the playtest got this key for free,
it will be a free game when it does release out of testing, and I'm really making this video because, well,
I like the game.
Let's start with the obvious. This game has a very Battlefield 2 Project Reality feel to it based on the visuals, and as much as I was concerned about that starting off, it really seemed to work, and after a couple minutes I was in the world and having a great time. The map we played completely put me back in the Battlefield 2 days, with a good combination of open areas, buildings, industrial sites, and most importantly, elevation. It wasn't just a simple flat map, and players who found themselves on roofs or in windows would quickly rack up the kills. The gameplay loop is very basic right now, and from the devs it seems that this was the first ever playtest to have more than 20 people, and I believe by the time the playtest had really got going, we had capped out at 64. For a completely free, community-developed standalone game, not a mod, this is really incredible to see. Squad leaders could drop very basic rallies and fobs to allow for squad and team spawning, and we had a couple objectives to fight over. It does look like there's an early stage ticket system, but I'm not too sure what the future plans are for game modes, since I'm gonna be honest, the biggest complaint I hear from squad, armor, and insurgency players is that after a while, the gameplay loop just really gets a bit dry. If Operation Harsh Doorstop can really nail the game modes, I think they'll have a lot of support. I had a lot of fun testing out the map, weapons, and running around with my squad and teammates, but the entire time, I was just so surprised at how much this actually felt like a real game. Yes, there's a lot of placeholder assets and sounds, some things have very basic functionality, but I see the vision and I'm completely on board. What seems to cause problems in your typical games is that at a certain point, development stops, slows down, maybe the game takes a direction that a very vocal part of the community dislikes, and you're just left to sit back on the sidelines and take it with the $30 game you don't really want to play anymore. In Operation Harsh Doorstop, the game is being developed with the community in mind, and those who play and support the game, like communities who have a large player base, if they create events, maybe they run servers, those guys are going to be able to directly impact the game in some way. Simple things like uniform patches, perhaps, from, let's say, your favorite content creator, or maybe the clan that you're a part of, or even teams who like to develop full-on modifications for the game, like Squad Star Wars mod Galactic Contention, will all be able to live in the Operation Harsh Doorstop universe, without the need for anyone to ever pay for an additional game. The community will never be split up, and if you want to play Harsh Doorstop Vietnam or Harsh Doorstop World War II, you can. You can simply play with your friends however you want to play, and then elect to support the game, the server communities, or creators if you choose to. This is huge since even now I get people asking me if buying Squad just for Galactic Contention is worth it. This integration and community-heavy focus is a really cool concept that I've seen in games like Rust or Escape from Tarkov. From Twitch drops to streamer items and collectibles and even creator codes, community integration has seen massive success for the games that do it right. But even those games have such a steep barrier of entry in the way that you have to first buy the game. A free tactical shooter sounds a bit crazy, and it honestly might be crazy, but based on what I played this past weekend, it actually works. Future plans also including things that we've come to expect in large tactical shooters, like base building and command abilities. And on the Drakeling Labs roadmap, we can see a bunch of to-do items including finishing up the source development kit for mod support, adding ground vehicles, implementing destructible environments, and even adding air and naval vehicles. When I look at this, I think back to the Battlefield 1942 days, where you'd have infantry fighting infantry battles, armor supporting each other and taking out armor targets, and naval ships and submarines doing their thing out in the water. It's absolutely incredible to think that this might even be a slight possibility in a tactical shooter, let alone one that's free. I think Operation Harsh Doorstop has a very bright future, and talking with BlueDrake, I can just feel his passion for the project, and the devs that I had a chance to play with were exactly the same way. What I would like to see sooner are more options and ways to ensure squad cohesion, since I do believe that if working with your squad feels good, then that will be the deciding factor to whether or not people will elect to not only spend their time playing it, but spend their time developing a community for it. The bones of a really cool and really fun tactical, free-to-play shooter are there, and I just can't wait to see where they go. If you do want updates on the project, go wishlist it on Steam, and you'll find other links to their Discord and how to support them further if you are interested. But what do you guys think? Is Operation Harsh Doorstop something that interests you? Would a free-to-play spiritual successor to Project Reality be something that you'd try? Let me know in the comments below, and if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. But that's it for me. Enjoy the little bit of gameplay here, and until next time, peace. If we could get smoked, do we...
Oh, bad Nate!
I'm moving. This one right here,
That's still bad Nate! I got him, and I got the MG in the window here. Friendly.
Slanging GL. Shoot that fucking RPG.
Yeah, where? I don't know where. Got him close across the road. Yo, you got an MG? You got a GL? Yeah, you're right. You got a GL. Yo, you see
I
the?
I have to leave from the squad.
You see the freaking yo, the truck northeast with the HESCO blocks? There's an MG posted up on there. Anymore.
We rally down, hell yeah. Okay, don't go out fucking door.
Yo, can someone grab this rifleman kit? We have a rifleman anywhere? Need ammo?
Is any of you guys able to grab
that
book?
God, dude, I can't even hear anything. Oh, God, dude. Dude, they're like west of this rally. Back glass clear. Oh man, dude. That was nonsense.